Hatte Hatte Harun Affair. This is a wondrous day for us to be together. And I'm so grateful that we're going to have this time to share. I'm grateful and I'm looking forward to our session at this time. And it's such an awesome morning for us to get together and to make this happen. As usual, we're going to get started. We're going to bow in, get some Asar stance. Hopefully, y'all have been really working that Asar stance. So we're beyond 10 minutes and moving upwards so that we get beyond that. Now, after Asar stance, as usual, we're going to get into our Qigong. We're going to get into our form exercises. And then we're going to be going all the way through the lunar cycle. We've started it. We're right there. We're all the way at the push. Because the feet don't move in this section, it's awesome so that we can get the rest of these movements done. It's just shifting the weight. So we're going to work on that. We're going to work on that part of the forms, shifting the weight. You'll be able to see me in a little bit better light today. And then what the goal is, as we head towards the end of the week, because we have an awesome new moon. Awesome new moon. And so we have some things that we'll be practicing. You want to get the form and under the new moon. And at the end, we'll talk about what that looks like right after wisdom from the sages of the ages, right before we part with our alternate nostril breathing and wisdom from the sages of the ages. All right, without any further, let's get moving. Let's get our bodies ready in position where we need them so we can make this happen. All right. Okay, let's get in. You want to have your feet in the Wu Chi position. Get a couple of breaths in. Bring it down in the pyramid hands. And we go ahead, we bow in to all the masters that have gone before us. We bow. Teacher to student, student to teacher. Pyramid hands. We're gonna shift all that weight to the right, picking up the left foot a little bit higher and a little bit wider than shoulders width. Set it down gently, balance the weight between the legs. Sit down, tuck the bottom. Open up the hands into the Asar stance position. And let's go for 20 breaths. Here we go. Get a little deeper, four breaths. In the pyramid hands. Shift the weight to the right leg, slide the left foot into the Wuchi position. Let the hands come down as we shake it out, opposite hand, opposite hand. Nice, nice, nice. Uchi position. Pyramid hands. Shift the weight to the right as we pick up the left, stepping a little bit wider than shoulders width. Heel first. Palms up and we're holding the golden balls. Two breaths. Into oneness. Into the turtle, out to the drawbridge. Point the hands between the legs. Into oneness. Rabbit through the chute. Into oneness. Elbows. I'm gonna pick up the pace. Into oneness. Right hand on top of left hand, palms up, thumbs touching beneath the navel. Rotate the left hand on top. Palms are facing each other. See a golden white light like the sun in between the palms of the hands. Into oneness. Into the turtle. Out to the drawbridge. Hands between the legs, two breaths. Into oneness. Pyramid hands. Shift the weight to the right, slide the left foot into the Wuchi position. Hands down, shake it out, opposite hand, opposite leg. All right, feet parallel, shoulders width. Bottom tucked, check your feet. All right. Into the position. Shoulders relaxed, two breaths. Palms forward, two breaths. Let the hands come down into the gathering. Remember, as you exhale, the knees bend. You inhale, the legs straighten, but do not lock. Using the bellows breathing. right, interlace the fingers, palms outward, right out in front of the heart. We're going to raise the hands into the heavens. 8 times. Here we go. Remember, we're coming up on the balls of the feet. Hands come on down into swinging arms. Come swing. Now remember the goal, starting off, is to get to your age. So if you can get that far easily, go for it. Goals to not be completely out of breath when you finish. Want to do this one every day. It's good for cleaning out the lymphatic system, moving the lymphatic fluid through the body, good for stimulating the immune system, resetting the parasympathetic and sympathetic nervous system, good for the cardiovascular and the cardiopulmonary systems. Sinking down, and we open the chest 5 times. Shake it out, opposite hand, opposite leg. Opposite hand, opposite leg. All right, left hand up, right hand down. Shoulders relaxed, breathing in. Out. In. Out. In. Out. In. Out. In. Out. Keep the right hand up. Breathe in with the left hand.
Breathe out, both hands come down. Come right in, the sun rises over the mountain and sun sets. All right, after this, we're going to ward off right and left four breaths.
You're muted, Inpu.
I think we.
There we go. Doing good, everyone. Keep it going. Keep it going. Going well. We'll join you momentarily. There we go.
One more. You're riding the grass of bird's tail, four breaths. All right, stepping back, shake it out. Feet parallel, shoulders width. We're gonna go four breaths all the way through to push. Well, here we go, sinking down, sun rises. And step back, shake it out. Feet parallel, shoulders width. Sinking down. All the way through with the flow. Straight through. Again. Again, sinking down. Again, sinking down. Again, again, sinking down. Again, sinking down. All right, shake it out. Opposite hand, opposite leg. All right. Feet parallel shoulders width. Right hand on top of left hand. Gonna shift the weight to the left. Turn. We're gonna wave the hands like clouds. Back to front and center, sun rises. And shake it out. Opposite hand, opposite leg. All right, grab a seat. Comfortable spot. Okay, I'm gonna sit so we can do our breathing exercises, our alternate nostril breathing exercise. So today, I'll take this right index finger and thumb, put them together, palms up on top of the right knee, right thumb blocking off right nostril, middle index finger in the center of the forehead. Breathing in. Out. In. Out. In. Out. Fire breath. Deep breath in. Release. Switching hands, no breath. Breathing in. Out. In. Out. In. Out. Fire breath. Deep breath in. Release. Both hands, thumb and index finger touching, resting on the palms, breathing in, out. Both nostrils push and pull with the bellows, breathing in, out. In, out. In. Out. Fire breath. Deep breath in. Chin down. Release. Nostrils should be working together nicely. Nicely, nicely. Yes, yes. All right. Today, we're going to get our wisdom from the sages of the ages. And today, it is going to come from let's see, what have we got here? We're gonna pull this. This is an oldie, open secret from Rumi. There we go, clearing the mind. Let's see, all right, so here we go.
This one is called Growing a Coat of Mail. And this is from the older version. Actually, since I pulled a Rumi, hold up. I'm going to get from the other bookshelf here a special one. Hold up. From the, yeah. We're going to go with this one. This was a more true translation. So I want to get this out there because I've been pushing particular one for a long time and it hasn't been the most true rendering from the original language. So this is the one we're working with now. Want to get that out there. Okay, so this is the book one. It's a new translation by Javed Mojadedi, who's a specialist not only in poetry and Near Eastern studies, but is also a language expert in the language that Rumi spoke. So during the time that he spoke it, so it's a more true as opposed to a more artistic rendition that Coleman Barks was doing, keeping aspects of, because again, Jalaluddin Rumi, peace be upon him, was a Muslim scholar. So a lot of his metaphor was to for folks to pursue a deeper or richer understanding. And so they've kind of neutered and pacified aspects of that for a Western audience. So we want to be able to, if we're going to appreciate and talk about the wisdom from the sages of the ages, we want to be able to do so in a way that honors their voice and honors the way in which they would have expressed themselves to the best of our ability. All right, so here we go. Okay, so this one is called How a Hare Killed the Tyrannical Lion. And this is in the midst of it. So we say, blessed is the one who follows righteousness, who gives up all their power for lowliness. If fate should dress you up in black like night, still it will help you in your hardest plight. If destiny should try to murder you, first it makes sure that you'll be born anew. If it waylays you, hurls you in a ditch, a tent for you in heaven it will pitch. By frightening you, know that he's being kind. In his safe kingdom space for you he'll find. This talk remains unfinished, but it's late. Now listen to the tale while I narrate. And so that's the intro. And then we get to the hare steps back from the lion when it approaches the well. And we'll go just a bit here and then we'll go. The lion now approached the well they'd found, but saw the hare retreat and turn around. Why is it you retreat, hare? What is wrong? Don't stop like that. Come forward and be strong. The hare screamed, oh, my feet have fled from me. My soul now trembles and desires to flee. Can you not see my face is turned so pale? About my inner state, it tells the tale. Since God has called the face a telltale clue, on this mystic focuses his view. Color and scent like bells make you aware. The horse's neigh informs you it's there. The sound of each thing thus gives it away. A door's creak differs from a donkey's bray. The prophet said in judging people's souls, a man stays hidden till his tongue unrolls. Complexion also shows what's in your heart. Have mercy on me. Plant love that won't part. A bright complexion is your thanks applause. A sickly one denies love and withdraws. I have spoken. All right. So there we go with today's session. So grateful everybody was able to join us and be present. Thank you all so much for being here, for working with us in whatever place that you receive this, so you hear my voice. Know that we are here to support you along this journey of making a consistent commitment to a lifestyle change. Please take your health seriously. Everything that you do, every day that you do these works, these practices, they will aid you. They'll be able to return to you your presence of mind, spirit, to give your body the guidance and direction that it desires from you, not from external sources. And with that, I say thank you. I say Hetep, which is peace. And I'm going to bow as we bow out, saying to all the masters that have gone before us, we bow. Teacher to student, student to teacher. Acknowledging the ancestors as we say Ashe. Paying homage and giving thanks to the eternal witness of the earth and the sky. I say to you, peace, Hetep. Ankh Ujah Seneb, life, health, and strength. It is a wondrous season. Be prepared, the new moon is coming. So as it comes, prepare yourself for your affirmations, your new things that you wish to accomplish during this cycle, the things that you need and want to accomplish to have them grow as the moon grows for this next year. I'm so grateful that we had this time together. Hetep.